Hello everyone, you told me that you would like to see some bigger bases, and so in collaboration with a good friend of mine, we built this beautiful 2x2. As you can see, it is a multi-TC 2x2 shell with two roof bunkers on the inside. This shell is split into four sections, using these fences to give more control during an online raid. You also have four bedrooms down here to respawn at and defend from. In the 2x2 starter core, we have some more storage, as well as my new unlootable TC room. Up here, we just have some more storage and space for some utility items. Going up here, you can find more bedrooms for quick respawns close to the shooting floor. On the shooting floor, we have this little outpost with a back room and some kits to fight off raiders who already got into the shooting floor. Here we have a combination of ramp and door peaks to give full vision on the inside and outside of the base. You also have these ladder hatches for quick access into and out of the shooting floor. You might wonder what all these frames are for. These are to give the peaks extra stability, which is very important during an online raid. But before I show you how to build this, I would like to thank Big Key for sponsoring this video. For those who don't know Big Key is the game's giveaway site. On there, they have free hourly giveaways where you have the chance to win the newest PC and console games, for example like Rust. How it works is simple. Find a game that you want and enter the game's giveaway by completing one short and simple free offer. Giveaways for all the games on the site happen every hour, so you can keep on entering new giveaways for a chance to win. If you create an account by using your YouTube or other social media account, you can get some free fast entry tickets. These fast entry tickets allow you to enter giveaways without completing an offer. If you create your account using my special link, you'll get even more free fast entry tickets, link on the screen and in the description below. Thanks again to BigKey.gg for sponsoring this video. To start off the build, we will place down one square foundation. This will get turned into our unlootable later. If you want to know how to build it, I will link the tutorial in the top right corner. From here, expand into a classic 2-loot room 2x2 with an airlock. You don't instantly have to upgrade everything to stone. If you only have wood for the beginning, that's totally fine. First, for some storage, we will begin this loot room with 4 large boxes, as well as our starter storage in the unlootable. Once you grow out of this and need to expand, add a double door to the front as well as a jump up here. On the next two squares, put windows and in the furthest away socket, a double door. For the next squares, put walls all around and two half-height floors with another floor on the second one. On the open square, add another jump up, again with a half-height floor. For the walls, put a single door frame on each of the sides and fill in the gaps. Another jump up goes above the first one. This time, the square next to it will get sealed off with a double door. Again, two single doors on opposite ends with windows in between. This floor will be the one attaching to the shooting floor. If you want another design, go ahead, this is just a suggestion. Once you have garage door, begin in to slowly fill in every socket of your base, starting in the core. Throw some cheap offline protection for the first night of wipe, try to upgrade the unlootable to sheet metal and get down the vending machine. Locker goes in its usual spot and now the drop boxes come. Place them after you upgraded it to sheet metal, as they can only be placed on the soft side of walls, and you being able to rotate the walls freely makes it a lot easier. Now, simple triangle honeycomb on the unlootable and the square in the front of it. Dropbox and locker are both BPs, so if you can't research them before the wipe, it is useful to live close to Bandit Camp, so you can buy them from there, or just go over to Bandit Camp and buy them there and instantly research them, as especially locker is a very useful BP to have. Behind this garage door, we have our main loot room. If you're interested in how to build it, I will link to the tutorial in the top right corner. Upgrade everything except the single door and the double door frames in the core to sheet metal. We upgrade the front single door to sheet metal to lighter cover our multi-TC gaps. We will also add some of your utility here. Choose whatever you want to have in your core. This is just my suggestion. And of course, don't forget the tuner can lamp, so that even at night you will still be able to access the unlootable. Up here, we will now begin with the usable honeycomb. For those interested in usable honeycomb, I will link the tutorial on it in the top right corner of this video. We will also have some honeycomb here and then our triangle with furnaces. The center triangle has to stay open because of the multi-TC that we are going to do later. You don't have to have furnaces here. If you watch the video on usable honeycomb, you might find another option. The same will be done on the opposite side again. Now do the last one with a 4 large box loot room. Again, over time, try to place as many garage doors as possible. Behind this window, we will have another loot room of the usable honeycomb video. If you want to know how to build it, it is also shown in the before mentioned tutorial. Just as a little tip, the top and the bottom of the shelf aren't the same, which is quite unique to such a loot room, because if they were the same, you wouldn't be able to access all of it. Under the jump up, we will have some storage. In the original, there's a shotgun trap here, which can be very useful for when people try to drop down. Now on this floor, we will make a bedroom behind all of the doors. Simply place down a locker, a bed and a small box. Another bag would fit here, which can also be useful so that people can have multiple respawns on the same floor if one of them were to be destroyed. Now do the same design again on all the other sides, behind all the other doors. In the space, all the floors above the 2x2 are being upgraded to sheet metal, as this will make defending an online a lot harder. Up here, we will add some lockers and bags for more respawns. Above this floor, add some drop boxes facing into the bedroom. In the bedroom, either do a bed and a locker or two beds like here. Now in the core, the last thing to add is the honeycomb on the backside that we weren't able to access before. Upgrading doesn't have to be in the order, just make sure that everything that you don't upgrade instantly will later still be accessible. To get a better understanding of the base, we will now set up the footprint. In front of the entrance and on the back add 5 triangles in a line like this. On the side opposite to the entrance, remove the center one. In front of the entrance and on the back add 5 triangles in a line like this. On the side opposite of the entrance, remove the center one. For these sides, we will do a simple multi-TC roof bunker. For this, build out 8 squares from here. Then cap it off with a triangle and come back with triangles that form these half moons, 4 in total. At the end of the line, you can place a square, capping it off. On each side of that square, place a raised triangle and then a lowered square, closing the gap between the foundations. Do the exact same again on the other side. From these extending squares, add 3 triangles, those will make up our entrance. Now, with triangles extending from the entrance, we will build a little path until we don't have building privilege anymore. On that triangle then, we will place down a TC and build it in with a window. This again will be the same for both sides. Upgrade these parts so that before everything is connected, they take longer to decay, so that later you won't have to do everything again. Now we will begin with the bunkers. For them, fill in these gaps with a triangle that is open to the inside. Above this floor, you will add this roof piece to cover it up, as you wouldn't be able to place a wall. Inside you will add 2 half-height floors, these will become your shelf. Here, add a doorframe, upgraded to the material of its neighboring wall. On a spot where these connect, this conditional model will appear. This should help with hiding the multi-TC gaps. Now, you can close off the bunker with a wall. After opening the bunker, you can place down a floor frame here. Place it so that you can't see one of the sides for the roof. This will close the gap that still existed above. Do the same again on the other side. Tell me in the comments down below if you're interested in an in-depth tutorial on multi-TC and roof bunkers. Now we will begin with our shell. For this, we will place garage doors next to the bunkers and double doors on these 4 squares. Next, we will build our shell. For this, build a ring of walls that is 3 walls high, but don't build in these squares, leave them sticking out, they will be of use later. Now we will begin with our shooting floor. For this, we will begin with floors with which we will fill in the gap of our shell and some more squares on the end. On the sides attaching to our main TC, you can place these 4 triangle frames that will later become more peaks. For this next step, we will surround the entire perimeter of the base with a combination of windows and doors. Next, we will then fill in all the holes we just created with either an embrasure or a single door. These triangles here can be left out on both sides and then be filled in with a ladder hatch. This creates an additional peak, but also gives a quick way up and down. Now to our roof. With the way that our shell is, we won't have any major gaps in our roof, which is nice, so that we don't have to give raiders who are on top of the base peeks down onto you. And for the few gaps that we will have, use some square frames in these 6 spots to close them off. The rest can just be filled in with normal frames. Now back on the ground, all the open double doors that we built here before will be turned into simple 1x1 bedrooms with a bed and a locker. Now onto the garage doors. Here we will expand this into a pretty standard entrance with windows and a single door airlock. Also, as soon as you build the shell, place down these frames to connect your external TCs so that your base won't decay. Here I will do the same entrance design again, but feel free to use any kind of design that you want. Back in the shooting floor, we will begin with the peak downs. First, we have to change our decenter squares into frames. Then next, place down a lower ramp, going to that direction. Make a build up to place a raised ramp on it. This should be an extension of the previous ramp. Because if we destroy the build up now, the original ramp will hold up the other ramp to create this amazing peak. Again, do the same thing here. First the low ramp, then the build up, and then the raised ramp, extending the first one. When building these, it is smart to carry some sort of weapon with you, so that you can destroy the build up quick and easy. Mirror this exactly to the other side. Tell me if you're interested in an entire video dedicated to peak downs. Until now, we had these three flying floors. By now, you should be able to guess that we will again have some ramp peaks here. Windows go all around, a low ramp on the floor, and then a raised ramp on the build up. Do this another time on the other side of the base. In the shooting floor, we will add these four single doors. These will separate the shooting floor into four sections, so that during an online raid, you won't lose your entire defenses at once. When making peak downs, one of the most important things to think about is stability, and the name of the game is frame. To give our peaks extra stability so that during an online raid they will stay up, we will place frames here. Some very important ones will be upgraded to metal, others will be left stone. The frames here next to the gaps are important to close them off so that enemies won't be able to look inside of your base. A lot of spaces that you could have frames will be left empty. This does not mean that you shouldn't put frames here, I just don't think they are necessary. If you light up here and close these doors, you will be able to place triangle roofs here to create quick dropdowns from the base that also can act as extra angles to surprise raiders close to your base from. If you have extra materials, this is a good spot to spend them on, as more frames mean more stability and a higher chance of defending an online raid. In the next step, we will upgrade these outside foundations to metal, so that soft-siding them to reduce the stability of your peaks becomes less appealing. While you're outside, upgrade the connection from your externals to your base to metal. Also, upgrade both of your externals to metal and add another garage door to the front to make them stronger. These externals are just a very basic option. A better option might be to make them their own independent flank base and or a compound gate, as shown in this video that I will also link to in the top right corner. On the inside, we will add these frames with chain links in them. These will section off the base during an online raid, while still allowing to fight off raiders through them. Here is the reason why we left out these foundations before. It is so that we have an easy to access oil refinery on the inside of our base, which can be very helpful to give enough low grade for the entire wipe. Next, we will upgrade these bunkers to armored. This will include the foundations, the wall, the floor frame, the door frame, as well as the single wall and both of the triangle foundations. do the same upgrades again on the other bunker. If you never played with bunkers like this, the idea is to split up your loot that even if your core gets raided, you still have a good amount of stuff. If you're scared of people soft setting into your bunkers, a good idea might be to, before you place this foundation, add a ramp on top of the foundation that you don't want soft sided. This will make it a lot harder. Last but not least, we get into our core. Here, replace the second door of the airlock with an armored one. Also, upgrade these two walls to armored, as they are the backsides of the bunkers. This is to reduce the effectiveness of splash damage. To bump up your TC square to 10 rockets, don't forget to upgrade it to armored. This can be done over time, as you can always just respawn inside of it and upgrade from there. This was the video, thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. I know the space is a lot bigger than normal, hence why the video is longer. Still, let me know what you think of it. So until next time, later!